You want to support Roland Martin Unfiltered? Be sure to join our Bring the Funk fan club. Every dollar that you give to us supports our daily digital show. There's only one daily digital show out here that keeps it black and keep it real. It's Roland Martin Unfiltered. Support the Roland Martin Unfiltered daily digital show by going to RolandMartinUnfiltered.com. You can make this possible.
All right, folks, I'm here in Indianapolis for the second consecutive year for the Steward Speakers Lecture Series. And so the brothers, the Steward brothers, Matthew Steward and his brother, they put this on. They've done this now for 30 years here in Indianapolis, and they have this State of Black America conversation. Last year, I moderated this conversation. We streamed it on Roland Martin Unfiltered. It was a conversation with Reverend Al Sharpton, Susan Taylor, as well as Michael Eric Dyson. This year's conversation features George Frazier, Reverend Ron, Lauren Simmons, and others as well. So looking forward to that conversation. In a moment, I'm going to talk with Matthew Steward about this. This is actually the third time I've been here. There he is. So he's been running around, staying busy. They do this. So first of all, so this is this is the second year I moderated. One other year, I actually was the keynote speaker.
Absolutely.
So y'all been doing this for three decades?
Three decades, yeah. 33 years we've been bringing in everybody who's anybody, thought leaders from across the country, from Harry Belafonte to Susan Taylor to Common to Dr. Mae Jemison. So over 100 thought leaders have come through this series.
Why? So what was the impetus? What caused you and your brother to say, we got to do this?
Yeah, so there's so much happening here in Indianapolis. I mean, our homicide rate was up. Our health rates were skyrocketing, where we were losing black males, black women far too soon. And so we knew that we had to bring in some national thought leaders to dialogue with us. So not only just to talk, because our tagline is more than just talk, but to develop a plan of action so that we can start of addressing these issues that are impacting our community.
And when you think about, again, moving folks to action, what has been the outgrowth of that? Have you actually seen people take what they've heard here and then put it into effect, into plan in the community?
Yeah, absolutely. So our churches, our communities of faith have started trying to help lower the homicide rate. And for the first time this year, we think our homicide rate will go down. Not significantly, but it's going trending in the right direction. So houses of faith have been going in their community three, four blocks around their churches and saying that this is not the community standard here. We cannot tolerate this. The village needs positive people. We're getting people back from reentry back into the community, and we have to make sure that those coming back to the village are valued and that they understand that this is the new code of conduct in our community.
You also have a youth component. Reverend Run this afternoon talked to largely African-American men, but also some other folks as well. Why is that also important to be able to integrate speaking to young folks as well as those who are attending the lecture series tonight?
Yeah, absolutely. So black males, again, I talked about that homicide rate of the 117 or 18 homicides this past year. 77 of those have been African-American males here in Indianapolis. And so we're trying to get grapple with that. And they understand Reverend Run because he speaks their language. And so to have 300-400 black males in a room where you have the founder of DMC in that room, they understand that, they listen, they connect.
Well, it's interesting. We were in the car right from the airport, and he was going to put on his suit and his collar because he's also a minister. Right. He said, should I change it? He had an Adidas tracksuit. I'm like, no, wear what you got on. Trust me, they'll identify with that.
Absolutely, absolutely. So, yeah, and the feedback that we already are beginning to receive from the young men there at that conference, there was a connection there. And so we will continue to develop them, move them into the direction that we need them to go in our community.
All right, folks, back to our Roland Martin Unfiltered video in just one moment.
All right, family, it's almost time. The holiday season is my favorite time of the year. And whether you celebrate Thanksgiving, Ramadan, Christmas, Kwanzaa, or New Year's, this is when you think about spending time with the people you love most. This is also the time to count your blessings and support those less fortunate and look at how you can have an impact on their lives. Well, I have the perfect opportunity for you to be a holiday hero and have a major impact on other families. Now, here's the deal. Right now, hundreds of thousands of Americans are sitting in jail without being convicted of a crime. Why? Because they lack the financial resources to pay their bail. Now, think about it. If you are arrested for any minor offense, you'll be taken directly to jail. If you don't have bail money, whether it's a few hundred or a few thousand dollars, you will stay there until a court date is scheduled. That could be days, weeks, or even months. Now, America's bail system is broken and has created a two-tier system of justice, one for the rich, another for the poor. Folks, freedom should be free. And that's why the Ebony Foundation has partnered with the Bail Project and is sponsoring the Home Mother Holiday campaign. Now, with your help, the goal is to bail out 1,000 people by New Year's Day. Now, a donation from you today can change someone's life tomorrow. And this is critical because people of color represent upwards of 90% of the jail population across the country. Now, when folks stay in jail, 90% of the people with misdemeanors end up pleading guilty because they want to get out of jail. However, when bail was paid, 50% of the cases were dismissed, and less than 2% received a jail sentence. Sometimes justice needs just us. To join the fight to be a holiday hero, you can donate 25, 50 bucks or more to help the Ebony Foundation bring our brothers and sisters home by the holiday. To donate, go to homebytheholiday.com. That's homebytheholiday.com. Please support them now. Now back to your Roland Martin Unfiltered video. We'll be right back.